It was always going to be a difficult decision to make to step down at any time. Our governance is that we do 2-year terms of office, and we are allowed to do, or our governance say that we can do 3 terms of office. I've got to the end of my second, and I had to make a decision as to whether I wanted to put myself forward for another 2-year term. I felt at this point in time, I think we've got to a little bit, there's still lots of work to do, and there's a lot happening within pharmacy, lots of decisions and changes, etc. Also, you know, the pharmacy profession moving forward and pharmacy technicians' roles still evolving. But I kind of just felt there's a little bit of a pause at the moment, and it's probably the right time to hand that over to somebody else that can actually take the profession forward for the next few years. We had an event in January where we invited some members, some key stakeholders, to a horizon scanning strategy event day, where we looked at APT UK's purpose, our role as the leadership body, and what our purpose really is for the next 3 years. So we've been evaluating that, and we've actually, we're turning that into our kind of strategy document for the next 3 years. And it kind of feels that it's right to hand that over to somebody else to actually take that forward. The other reason also is that I have retired from the NHS. I don't work in absolute practice as a pharmacy technician anymore. I still do work as a consultant for an awarding body, a quality assuring pharmacy technician qualifications and their delivery. So I felt that, again, it's probably the right time to have a precedent that is closer to the pharmacy technician workforce in terms of their role, their evolving roles, you know, on the shop floor and in all of the different sectors. So it was a combination of reasons. Also, you know, life, you have to look at your work-life balance. You have to look at what your family commitments are and how else you could maybe better serve the profession, as my career is actually naturally coming to a close as I have retired. And It was a right decision for this time, and to enable somebody, another president, to be able to start with a 3-year strategy and actually take that forward. When I took up the presidency in 2014 now, we'd just actually become a limited by guarantee company as a kind of a registered company. So that was actually quite a step forward for us. So I saw my challenge as taking the organisation forward within that framework, but actually modernising the way that we run, looking at our systems, kind of trying to raise our profile with more engagement with pharmacy technicians in all sectors. We'd had a little bit of a thought from the profession that we were just hospital pharmacy technician representatives, and that was never our remit. We were always the leadership body for all pharmacy technicians in all sectors. So that was some of my, you know, that was some of my personal challenge to try and raise the profile of APT UK throughout all of the sectors and with the pharmacy profession in general. And I do think that I hope I've made a difference. I'm being told I have, but it's also being for the pharmacy profession to be aware that APT UK is here and we are the professional voice for pharmacy technicians, and have that recognition. The huge challenge, and I am going to throw this challenge out constantly, probably within the next 6 months while I support APT UK up to the end of the year. I'm going to throw the challenge out that we are the professional leadership body, and we've got that recognition. However, we are working on volunteers under on a voluntary basis. Workforce pressure, workplace pressure has meant that pharmacy technicians, everybody, not just pharmacy technicians, is working to full capacity in their day job. And it's a real challenge to actually ask people to do another full day's work, voluntary. And I think that there is the challenge for the profession to support APT UK as the professional leadership for pharmacy technicians, and just to try to support it more so that it can be the organisation that it actually aspires to and what it wants to deliver on. I mean, during the last 2 years, I have collaborated with a number of organisations, and we've got formal memorandum of understandings in place. It's about actually how we take those forward, and it's about actually how we work together as a profession, the whole team, thinking about, you know, we're not pharmacists, we're not pharmacy technicians, and it's not support staff. And I think the GPHC are clear on this whole team approach, and that's how I see it. It's about supporting everybody that delivers the services for patients. And I will keep saying this, that we need to be very mindful and clear that actually we're here for patients, we're not here for our own self-gratification. We are here to actually serve the patients and to deliver the services that we can to patients as safely as possible.